if there's any, not in terms of distribution, who we distribute to, we don't have that information to hand with us. I mean, I could get it to you separately, but...
Well, that'd be helpful.
Yeah, 2 points. I mean, there's an area that my ward where I've raised the issue, particularly with communication over the period of 20 years, about would you please, you know, put this communication into this area of my ward? And at the time, we said, oh, it's you know, a dangerous area, we don't go in there. Well, you know, I've been going in there for 20 odd years, I've never had a problem in there at all. And this was, you know, 18 years ago. Now, things have changed since 18 years. Anyway, why, you know, do you persistently not exclude these areas? And, you know, also, you know, the council, in the past, the council put out communications with you. It needs to reach all areas because these are really essential communications for essential people in certain areas of the world. You're not distributing to some of those areas.
As I said previously, I don't know the distribution areas that we deliver to in great detail. If we to distribute to your area, we'd have to cut from another area, and then we'd have the same argument with another area. Simple fact is, unfortunately, we can't distribute to every home. We are a commercial business, as well as a newspaper.
Dave. Thank you very much, Chair. I actually live and represent all the areas. We don't receive your opinion. But I do read the online service that you supply. You did say early on average about 15,000 people, was it?
That's an extra 15,000.
How many people do you have then followers? Do you know?
We have our unique users, our audience is
is that the comments have been made regularly. It's something I alluded to before I was going to the cabinet member. And it's being able to get the information out. I did state that we were trying to do that through our constituencies. And there are lots of different ways of having this capacity, disseminating information. I would like to follow up on the Councillor Waiting made earlier on, was that the ability to actually have to stuff printed. Because the matter is disseminated, but there are areas where you can go regularly because we have to disable the newspaper on the frontage as anybody comes in here for one's help. It's areas like that, doctor's surgeries, libraries, where these things can be placed readily for the community to use. So there's lots of things that need to be looked at and addressed to make sure that we get the right answer.
Thank you, I agree with you. You know, we do live in a range, and there are several ways now where we can communicate effectively with people and engage with people. And actually, what we find now is we have a much more engaged audience online than what we've ever done before, and there's no reason why that couldn't be the case for all of the council.
Can I just say online, this council identified, it's 2 years ago now, so it is a bit out of date. We identified 50,000 people in Wirral who've had no access or cannot use the internet. So the internet is a powerful medium, but it's not the panacea. It's good for us who can go online and read it, of course it is, but there are 50,000 people out there who are disadvantaged through one way or another, but cannot access or will not access the internet. Thank you. That's all.
Thank you.
speak up loud.
Excuse me. This is actually a private meeting held in public.
Jack, can you switch your microphone on?
My microphone is on. Oh, God. People hear me. We don't have a microphone. I will not have people from the public gallery shouting. I just will not have it. So please have a bit of decorum.
I think to be fair, Chair.
And Jeff, that includes you as well. Thank you, Jeff. My microphone is on. Thank you, Paul. So, you say you live to 97,000 roughly people. I want to know how you came to that figure. And the next part of the question is that you've mentioned in response to Councillor Williams' question that those areas that you don't deliver to, that's a mixture of the problem of capacity, you can't find people to deliver it, and also you don't deliver there because it's been deemed unsafe. How then, working for the council, would you be able to deliver to these places? Because the issue here is that not everyone is receiving information from the council. Is Wirral going to be able to deliver information? You suggested that.
In terms of the council
mentioned that it's a capacity issue, if you literally have an ability they'd love to work with the council, and you've had a meeting, and it sounds all singing and dancing to me. Gerry said he asked the Wirral Globe to deliver to his area when he was elected in 2008, and he's still waiting. Now, I live in Wirral West, which I would think is one of your target areas. Now, for the last year, I've been volunteering at Pensby Library, and you talked about your expertise of delivering. Now, I live in one of the highest target areas, I would think, in Wirral. And I'm getting people coming into the library every Monday, every Thursday, and they're coming from Heswell, they're coming from Pensby, Barnston, Thingwall and Airby, and haven't received copies of the Wirral Globe. Now the Wirral News, your competitor, I might add, we're not a competitor, and we won't be, but they are. They deliver 30 copies of the Wirral News to Pensby Library every Wednesday night. So when I open on a Thursday, they're there. 12 months ago, I rang the Wirral Globe, because I'm there to try and facilitate to every resident in our ward and outside of our ward if it happens. I asked the Wirral Globe, would they replicate what the Wirral News are doing 12 months ago. 12 months on, I've made 6 phone calls to the office, the local office here. Now, a fortnight ago, in frustration really, I googled Wirral News, and I got your distribution telephone number, because I'd spoken to everybody else, and I thought I'll go straight to distribution. Well, I hope you're aware, your distribution centre is in Southampton. Now I'm trying, this is a fortnight ago before this calling came in, I might add. I was speaking to a gentleman in Southampton, and I was trying to explain to him where Pensby Library was, in Pensby. Not only didn't he know where Pensby was, he didn't know where the Wirral was. So when you come here and you say you want to actively engage with the council, and you talk about your expertise, and I would hope that you will go away, and I would hope from next week, when I open Pensby Library on Thursday morning, a week tomorrow, there'll be 20, 30 copies of the Wirral Globe alongside the copies of the Wirral News, so I can facilitate the people in the target areas. I actually think you're doing a disservice to your advertisers who are paying you good money to advertise in your paper, to deliver papers in places like, the places I've mentioned, I won't mention them. So it's, to me, it does sound a bit rich, the things that you've been saying, because we've said, we're not going to go into competition with you. We want to reach all our residents to tell them about our services. Nothing more. And what we also want to do is to cut costs. That's what this is about. It's about delivering to 147,000 households and cutting costs. That's what this is about. All the other things that have been mentioned around this table are superfluous, really. So please, take that away with you about delivering. There's 20 copies, 30 copies to Pensby Library every week. Thank you. And thank you for coming today. No, there's no more questions, Jim. Thank you. this table are muttering to one another and using mobile telephones, which I didn't see you use with that. So please keep it to your own.
Thank you, Sir, for my
heart here. Thank you, sir. You've got 5 minutes.
Thank you, Chair. I wasn't planning on going into detail with regards to the legal position, but rather ask members to ask any questions with regards to any questions or issues that they have. The legal position is pretty much defined within the report itself. I'm aware of obviously a number of points that have been made, and maybe depending on the questions asked, I'm able to pick up the other points that have been made by others.
Tom first, then Chris.
Thank you, Chair. And so, just putting on your comments on what Simon Scott said about specifically the injunctions that were given from government to Greenwich and other councils. Have you studied that? What's your opinion of that? And my second question is, the cabinet member referred to that you would have a final sign off of this new newspaper, information sheet, whatever we're calling it. So I'm sure you've got many talents, but is Edgar Chief one of them?
Yes, through you, Chair. With regards to the position on Greenwich, as I understand the position, it's been an ongoing, long-standing dispute with regards to the publication that Greenwich were pursuing and have been for some time. There are a number of differences with regards to the publication they were engaged in terms of Greenwich Times, which was known. Obviously, it was on a weekly basis. A direction was issued by the Secretary of State to Greenwich Council, effectively requiring them to comply with the provisions of the code. And the Secretary of State is indeed entitled to issue such a direction in his capacity. That was then subsequently challenged by Greenwich, by way of JR, and ultimately resulted within this year in consent order being. Respect to those proceedings. Details of which I was considered, and the arrangements are, as I understand it, for that publication to cease. However, in saying that, as I also understand the position, there is a cabinet decision that Greenwich have made for a further publication to be pursued on a fortnightly basis. So it's a little bit unclear as to the discussions that clearly have had and been had between the parties as part of the hydro proceedings and the rationale and the schedule and details set out within the schedule of a particular court order, how that has been interpreted and applied, because there seems to be some confusion and must be with regards to that order and the cabinet decision that Greenwich have also noticed made with regards to a formality publication. So there is still some confusion with that with regards to the code and its application, particularly in this area. I think it is fair to say that a balance is required to be struck. The obligation and duty, there is a legal duty upon this council to consider and have regard to the Publicity Code. That is a legal obligation that we must have and do. And it's important that we do discharge that. Hence, the reason why the report does make reference to that obligation and duty. As with all matters, because the requirement is to have regard, any departure from that guidance must be justified. And the test is significantly high, as you would expect, because Secretary of State guidance should not be departed from London. There needs to be sound justification for it, and those arguments have been articulated within the report. You've also heard further information and evidence with regards to issues around the gap and circulation issues and publication. Difficulties and issues, and which forms the substantive part of the rationale for why this particular initiative was seen to be appropriate, and why, therefore, departure from the code was also considered to be reasonable and justified. In terms of the legal position, the rationale that has been articulated within the report is a reasonable and justifiable rationale. It meets, in my opinion, the whether reasonable test. It's not an irrational decision that has been arrived at. However, that does not mean that there is not going to be differences in opinion.